Respect the DJ. DJ with DJ Swim.
What's good? By Jenez. Remember, we are G Live at the original DJ Quest. I'm playing straight blend. You can't download this shit.
Soul in my voice, give you quick feet. I don't know what it's like to not dig deep.
hip-hop shit. Hip squeaks, the tides come in the earth shakes. Big shout out to Joel Ortiz.
Wins, I'm your worst.
Joel Ortiz, Brooklyn, stand up.
1980, how can your age even matter when you rhyme this crazy? Oh, man, I gotta thank the Lord, cause when this pen in my hand, I don't think that hard. It just happens. Rip action, classic in the making. I kick back.
Big shout out to Big Daddy Kane.
Happy, I'm amazing. Look at me, gazing in my eyes. See the poverty? Now understand why me and this music is gotta be. It's something that's inside of me, and I can't shake it. So I embrace it and let y'all taste it. Oh, man, this is hip hop. Hands up if you forever been a hip hop. I wake up hip hop, go to sleep hip hop. Dream about hip hop, cause I am hip hop.
Oh, man. This next break gonna have you bananas.
Up if you forever
going, what the fuck?
I wake up hip hop, go to sleep hip hop. Dream about hip hop, cause I am
DJ Quest.
Not ready for this shit.
DJ Quest,
respect the DJ. DJ, DJ Swift.
It's hell, another rock to sell. People look at you like you's the user.
Straight blend.
But they don't know about the stress filled days. Baby on the way, mad bills to pay. That's why you drink Tangeray. So you can
go check out my sound wish. My sound clown.
The living so devil.
The mix is up.
I remember I was just like you, smoking blunts with my crew, flipping over 62s. Cause GED wasn't BIG. I had to get PAD. That's why my moms hate me. She was forced to kick me out, no doubt. And I figured out, mix went for 20 down south. Packed up my tools for my raw power move. Block 19 for casket and flower moves. But Trump's trying to stop my flow. And what they don't know will show on the autopsy. Went to see Poppy to cop me a brick. Asked for such a sign and he wasn't trying to hear it. Smoking mad Newports cause I'm doing court.
DJ Quest.
That I caught the rich man. Like the gingerbread man, you better have your cat in hand, cause man.
Respect the DJ, DJ, with DJ Swear.
Raindrops, drop top, smoking, no cooking, the hot box.
Cricket,
fucking on your bitch, yeah, that.
Aw, shit.
Getting up, in the crock pot.
Migos,
from
the buster.
The nigga.
Hey.
I don't try nobody grit the
who would have thought this shit would fucking sound great?
DJ Quest.
That's
who. Bad
emotion,
bad. Cooking up dope with a Uzi. My niggas is savage, ruthless. We got 30.
Big shot of Tony.
My bitch is bad emotion, bad. Cooking up dope with a Uzi.
Dope.
My niggas is savage, ruthless.
Hey.
We got 30s and 100 rounds too.
DJ Quest.
Give me some hoe.
What up?
kid. I know shit is rough doing your bid. When the cops came, you should've slipped.
Nah.
Crib, fucking black, no time.
Nah.
Looking back, cause
Miguel?
Plus, congratulations.
Nah, good.
Got a
Sambi.
I heard he looks like you. Why don't your lady write you?
Yes, sir.
She should visit, that's when she got hyped.
Remember when you were flipping,
talking about
the
ass.
DJ, the DJ, DJ Swift.
I was like, yeah, shorty don't care. She a snake too. Fucking with them niggas from that fake crew that hate you. But yo, guess who got shot in the dome piece? Jerome's niece on her way home from Jones Beach is bugged. Plus, little Rob is selling drugs on the dime. Hanging out with young thugs that all carry nines. And nighttime is more tripe than ever. What up with Cormega? Did you see him or y'all together? If sold and hold a fort down, represent to the fullest.
Strictly
take
West Blend.
I'm ice and bullet. I left
go to my SoundCloud page. Congress. I got a mix up there.
Was my nigga with put
Strictly Blend, Volume 1.
One love, one love, one love, one love, one love, one love.
I give everybody love.
Havana, no.
That's right, Camila. Over that Dwick beat.
Get back to you, Selena. Nah. Oh, but my heart is in Havana.
And we heard it first.
Respect the DJ. DJ with DJ Swift.
Strictly Blend. Yeah, this is the sound of DJ Quest live on the set. I represent Respect the DJ with DJ Swift. DTFRing.com. Queen's finest DJs, let's go! Around. If you want to hear the rest of my blends, go to soundcloud.com/ the original DJ Quest. You can hear that mix without any interruptions. It's a little mini mix. Volume 2 is already in the works. Back to our programming.
Session. I'm not really sure if you've been checking. I'm progressing. I just heard my songs is popping out in Macedonia and even Serbia. I don't mean to burden you. If you got a man since then, I understand. Last thing I want
to
do is
you're not truly respect the DJ Swift.
And he probably never hear my shit again. And I need every single sound scan. But if you sing,
DJ
you
Quest, live in the set.
I'm in your town feeding for another round. I was counting.
Mathematics.
More patient than a Browns fan. With that chip probably on your shoulder because I forgot to hit back.
Shout to John 40.
Apologies are said, but often never meant.
Remember, we fucked that out.
The message
Quest.
Never sent now.
We find his DJs, let's go.
Stranger, it's been a minute.
This joint is fucking fire.
Last kid. By the way, just
DJ Quest.
And I won't let
this Saturday, July 14th, live at Embassy Live.
All in the sky.
We got the homie special at the building.
Who am I vibe?
Get tickets, get them at Everbright.
Your body, I don't do this often. But since recruit
shout out to Frank.
Isn't an option due to unusual rain and thunder. Baby, I wonder. Baby, I wonder.
Can't forget, rest in peace, Junior.
Yeah, yeah. Let me talk. Let me talk.
I keep seeing footage of a young boy beating. Knives and machetes left a little boy leaking. Tried to find help, but he wouldn't stop bleeding. Out of city yelling, Junior couldn't keep his heart beating. Dear mama, know your son is way too young to say goodbye. And the casket is way too cold to be inside. And it hurts more seeing him struggle. He must have cried. Close my eyes, cause I don't wanna imagine if that was my same age as my own son. Just 10 days apart from my own son. Dear God, where you at? Cause it feel like you losing and devil winning. We trapped in a circle of balance forever spinning. Still balling, playing a game, we never winning. Find us in the funeral homes or any prison. Heart broke, wiping my tears, we losing peers. Incarcerate us deep in the mountains, we losing years. Dark days, babies is dying from bullet strays. White cop ready to shoot, I feel enslaved. Instead of seeing our kids go to college, we digging graves. What's the future for my daughter and son? I feel afraid. The niggas say, man, don't be quiet. You done made 100 songs perpetuating violence. Oh, now you woke, but you trying to kick knowledge. I tell them not really, I'm just tired of being silent.
Lord have mercy. Yeah, I'll give anything in this world just so I can spend time with you. Just to spend one more time with you. Know that it hurt me. It broke me down now that you're gone. And I couldn't say bye to you. No, I couldn't say bye to you. I don't know what to do.
We got a dope segment. Want this to be true.
Every time I close my eyes, I just keep picturing you. I don't know what to do. Don't want this to be true. Every time I close my eyes, I just keep picturing you.
We living in a state of emergency. If only Junior would have made it to the emergency.
I'm gonna let this one rock out.
Nowadays, hard to see who's the enemy.
Rest in peace to Junior and his family.
For mistaken identity.
Gone but not forgotten.
Oh, what kind of world do we live in? Our kids ain't growing up in George Zimmerman is living. Hard to find hope when our country case children. When our youth contemplate suicide, they hate living. Dead rappers on my timeline. It's like God sending odd signs. Now academics got a voice. These is dark times. When the music needs a message, just give them dark lines. Remember, only when it's dark you see the stars shine. And I'm guilty of these same things I'm rapping about. Me and 80 did some shit I can't rap about. Voices screaming, you too grown to keep acting out. You owe them more, give them more than what they rap about. One time for Junior, his last steps on a Bronx block. We seen it, his last breath in his cold world. Didn't deserve it, his sad death. It's 1,000 more just like him. What else next? Dear Lord, think I lost my religion on these streets. The devil keep taking our babies on these streets. Is it our fault we never asked to be street? And tell Trump, give us that pardon for Big Meech.
Lord have mercy. Yeah, I'll give anything in this world just so I can spend time with you. Just to spend one more time with you. Know that it hurt me. It broke me down now that you're gone. And I couldn't say bye to you. No, I couldn't say bye to you. I don't know what to do. Don't want this to be true. Every time I close my eyes, I just keep picturing you. I don't know what to do. Don't want this to be true. Every time I close my eyes, I just keep picturing you. You.
DJ Swift.
We just be killing it with our own shit.
You mofo.
Yeah.
My passion holder savagely, my swag controller, ash the blunt and pass the doja.
I told you, brought some heat with him.
To Yoda basket with a Jack and Cola. I'm making Jack.
When you heard this first.
Packets of paper package. I'm actively taking orders. Hit me, you can match the quota. Catch me in a satin kimono. Colors catching the swatch in my logo. Matching the mountains as Captain Snow though. Saving for that Lamborghini. Take it to Santorini. Eating some langoustines. My cap is black and it's solo. If you feel the fit is legit, then come snap a photo and at my swag on the social. That's all you dying for Toto. Are you dying for Polo? Are you dying for Dio? Or are you just riding for promos? Oh no.
Big shout to Mark.
We don't wear designer.
He's an IG straight from Florida.
Own the Prada. Jesus wearing Santa.
What up, my brother?
Wearing Prada. Huffy on my sleeve. I'm so fashion.
DJ Quest.
We don't wear designer. We don't wear designer. Gotta own the.
It's a smooth shit right here.
Prada. Jesus wearing sandals, never wearing Prada. Puppy on my sleeve, I'm so fashion forward. Read me all my options, tell my son we Lonzo ballin'. I've been on one for a minute, and I don't know what you call it. If there's karma, I'm all in, round the world just like I'm calming. Never been to San Diego, hit him up, tell him I'm touring.
Yeah,
I'm foreign, just tell him that I'm important. Keep it on, I need to know, you should know it, then I'm important. If I'm spending on a bottle, then you should let me pour it. If you saw my hand, then trust me, you
would. Yo, Gina, I said, what up, Mark?
Open up my closet, reaching out for what's the.
What up, Tracy?
Don't matter what it costs, it got some value cause I wore it. If you never took a risk, then you probably couldn't afford it. That's word to my Tims, them boots were made for walking. We don't wear designer, we don't wear designer. Gotta own the Prada, gotta own the Prada.
DJ Quest.
Jesus wearing sandals, never wearing Prada. Huffy on my sleeve, I'm so fashion forward. We don't
designer,
designer.
Gotta
own the product.
Somebody pull out the pen and pencil.
Wearing sandals, devil wearing
the black book out.
Huffy on my sleeve, I'm so
fat. Giant down thoughts.
I'm cold, Steve Austin, stunner flow. Complimented like fucks of me. We both know I give none of those. I'ma just go ahead and claim it. I mean it as far as the summer goes. Tie tie when the sun is.
Bitch, say, to the wife, break up by
it's gonna
G-Nex.
Go, yeah, it's gonna go down. Yeah, it's about to go down.
August 3rd, it goes down on the boat.
Oh, well, I bet you.
Boat party.
Now, I do the shit for my family and I do it for my hometown.
More details when I come back.
It's creaking, I swear I never gonna drown. It's on my, yeah, you might not know me, dear. Rap act so full is here. That's why I know no
shit.
It's for all to see. Giving that quality. I'm who they wanna be.
That I mean, straight smooth shit.
But then you need to face it, that they're basic. And I'm an asshole who don't take
shit.
And
I work dope second.
All this will make sense. Like I got a twin and we take ships. I got a full house. We all in it. We all sin. Don't judge me. My guest
respect
Jesus.
Don't
crush
it.
I like him. You can't touch
me. DJ Swear. One, two, one, two, one, two.
Respect the DJ.
Respect the DJ with DJ
Swear. Yeah. Hey, DJ.
We are live in the building. We are live in the rec. What's going on? What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? We are here at Respect the DJ with DJ Swift. That is me. Yes, you are watching Respect the DJ on live on DTFradio.com. We're also live on that DTF Radio mobile app. Yes, yes, yes. You can also catch us live streaming on that ustream.tv/DTF Radio. We are live streaming there. We got a dope show lined up for you today. Here on Respect the DJ, we pay respect to the DJ, the turntablist, the mixer, the master, the mixer, the master, the cutter, the scratcher, the mood setter, the beat catcher, the foundation, the AKA the disc jockey, AKA the DJ.
Yeah,
and this thing we call hip hop. I like to say big shouts to my man DJ Quest doing the damn thing as
brother.
Always. How you doing?
Chilling, bro. Just giving people a little taste of my Strictly Blends mix I got out of SoundCloud right now.
Yo,
that's
yo.
That's a quick plug-in, right?
No, I like that. I like that. I actually like that mix that you have. Y'all got to go check that out on his SoundCloud page. It's mean. It's a mini mix. Nothing too long. It's good to get you through your train ride or through your little jog, your workout. You know, but Quest, how was your week, man? How's your holiday week? How's your 4th of July?
I went out to PA for a little bit, you know.
Nice.
With the fam.
I saw you playing with your drone.
Flying, flying my new toy, the drone.
Yeah.
DJI, that Maverick Air is no joke.
Ooh, we got sound effects again.
Gunshot for that.
Word.
You know what I'm saying? Damn, we took it over to Hangar Bar 11 on Friday. My man Aster, crazy.
You was that a saying? Birthday party or was that
yeah,
just
a regular night, you know?
Nice.
Good vibe, good vibe.
Nice, nice. Friday night was definitely a good vibe. You was DJing at Hangar. I was over at Stacks. Stack Sports Bar, Upper East Side on 77th and 2nd Ave. We had a good time over there. Good food, good drinks, you know, doing what we do. Then we had our Sunday brunch, you know what I'm saying? It was our third installment of the Z Boozy brunch over at Karma Lounge. Y'all got to come check it out from 2 to 8. From 2 p.m. to 8 p.m., day party. We got chicken and waffles. We got drinks. We have happy hour through the whole event. So, you know, it's totally worth it. And you it's grandfathered in, so that means you can smoke in there. It's not 420 friendly, but you can smoke a cigar. You can smoke
hookahs
all night, man. Like they have some bomb hookahs in there, too. But I know for those that's watching right now, y'all see, I got somebody next to me. We got our guest for the day in the building right now.
What's up, dude
is a producer, an engineer. Well, first off, he's a musician, engineer, producer, songwriter, and he owns his own company as well, if I'm not mistaken.
I have my own production company. Yeah.
Yes, yes. Put your hands together for Mark, a.k.a. Malof. Malfo, my bad. I'm doing good. I'm thank you for coming here. Thank you for trekking it through that hot summer air out there.
Thank you for having me. I got stuck in some of that, you know, New York City traffic.
Oh yeah, man. Yeah. That New York City traffic is no joke, bro. It is no joke. So how was your week, bro?
Well, my week was pretty entertaining. I just had an Earwax Sessions performance.
Okay.
At an Amityville Music Hall.
All right.
And basically I had like three of the artists that were featured on my project on stage with me.
All right.
And we just spit for the night. It's why my voice is kind of shot right now.
Oh man.
I sound a little hoarse, but
how was the energy in there, man? How was the energy?
The energy was good. You know, I had everyone vibing and everyone stayed for my whole set. So
oh, that's what's up.
I was feeling that.
That's what's up, man. That's always a good look.
Yeah.
That's what's up. That's what's up, man. So here, just so y'all know, on Respect the DJ, we like to touch base and talk about a little current event. Definitely if there's music in the current event, you know we like to talk about it. So right now, we wasn't here last week because it was the 4th of July fell on the day, and you know, everybody was doing something with family or had something going on, so we kind of took the day off. And now we wasn't able to talk about it then, but we're going to talk about it now. The new Drake album, the Meek Mill album. Right now, Drake's album is killing the charts,
yes,
bro.
It is.
Like, I was just skimming through iTunes the other day, yesterday actually, and I gotta say, like, you know, in their playlist for like new stuff and like what's hitting, it's literally like half of his album.
No, I know.
Like
he's,
literally
he's
half
top.
Of Drake right
he's
now.
He's right there on the top, yeah.
Yo, he is killing the market. Quest, how was it for you? Did you find yourself playing? Finding yourself playing In My Feelings and all these new Drake songs.
Oh, man, yo. All I could say is I'm blowing up for y'all. I'm
going to play
that
next. Well, you see how it is,
yo,
man.
Yo, reached out to Tony Heathcliff. Yo, this guy, we were in the highway. He made us pull over out of nowhere, and he popped a song in and started doing the dance.
Are you serious? He did the challenge on the highway?
Everybody check out my boy Tony Heathcliff page. He's the funniest shit in the world.
Big shout out to Tony.
That dance, In My Feelings dance.
Yo, that challenge is swarming the internet.
Yo, I just feel everybody like knows Swift's going to do one tonight, I heard. The club.
Nah, that's negative. Gunshots on that one. You're not going to get me to do the In My Feelings challenge. It's not going down. Meek Mill dropped. He dropped his EP, Summer of Legends, I believe it's called.
Yes.
And I gotta honestly say, he had four tracks, and it's kind of his EP is kind of better than all of Good Music's EPs.
We got a couple. A Boogie with a Hoodie came out with an EP last week.
Right. Yeah.
Casanova.
Yeah. There's a lot of good music that came out.
A lot of music came out the last 2 weeks.
I didn't even get to hear all of it yet. So.
Yeah, I haven't even.
Carter Crow Dares.
Who?
Jay-Z and Beyonce.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That was just mean. That was just mean what they did to Nas. They just dropped.
Yeah, Nas, man.
Yeah, they dropped the same weekend as Nas. Like, yo, that's real crazy. How you going to do that? You know, but also we also had those kids in Thailand. They finally got saved. They were like in that cave for a few days, like 6 days, I believe it was, something like that. Like possible. They thought they were gonna get drowned in there because it was gonna flood all the way to the top. Like, that's scary, bro.
There was a moment it was saying it might take a month or so to get them out.
Yeah.
It was looking kind of crazy.
Yo, the fact that they were able to go in and get all six of them out, like.
Shout them out.
Yes.
Word, man. Shout out to all those that was involved in working hard to get those kids out. Good looking. That's what's showing real humanity. We also had a big weekend going on. We had the Video Music Box 35th anniversary went on last Saturday. I mean, I wasn't able to go. I wasn't able to be at that event personally. My man Jedi, my boy Jimmy was at the spot. Also, a big friend of the show, DJ Cool KG, was heavy
on
up there.
Stage,
he was on stage,
yo,
man.
Yo, shout out to Cool KG, y'all, for real. Yeah,
this guy is everywhere. He is everywhere. I mean, first off, I'm not even gonna run down the entire lineup, but I gotta say, Ralph McDaniels really outdid MTV.
Yo, for real.
Yo, MTV's.
He
had 40 acts, but I mean, like, I'm just gonna run down a couple. He had Special Ed, Black Moon, Fat Joe, Nice and Smooth, Das FX, DJ Scratch on the set, nice. Chuck Chill Out in the building, Smooth the Hustler.
Ted Smooth.
Yo, Ted Smooth was there, Trigger the Gambler, Large Professor performed, In Touch the R&B group, Twin Hype, M.O.P. I mean, first off, just the fact that he had In Touch, Twin Hype, and then you could say M.O.P. was still on the same bill. UMC's was there as well. Craig G, Blase, and the list goes on. It was 40 heavy hitters. And, I mean, like,
MTV,
that's...
MTV should hire Ralph McDaniels the next time we want to do a party.
Yo, listen, yo, MTV, hear us out. For real. Y'all need to really take note of what Ralph McDaniels was doing. That was, like, the real hip-hop and R&B, like, video show. You know,
the hip hop phone made that one call and they were all out.
Yo, everybody was with it at the 35th anniversary, and I mean, like, there was more heads that was just in the like in the crowd in the building.
It was crazy because from 1 p.m. to 9 p.m. like
that's a day.
That's a whole day.
That
like,
is the whole day.
That's a day. And you know what's the dope thing about it? It was like, because I was watching everybody's IG because I was doing a barbecue. I had to do a family reunion that day, so I was on my private party move. But on the IG, you literally seeing that it was like the illest mixtape you could listen to, but visually. Like, everybody was only doing their bangers. It wasn't just album cuts or this. It was what made them. They did it, came in, dropped the mic, fucked it up, walked out. Next group. You know what I'm saying?
And the weather, you couldn't have asked for anything better.
Yo, Saturday was like the best day of the year so far.
For an awesome, epic, legend hip-hop day.
Right. Mark, were you able to partake in the...
I wasn't. This weekend, honestly, I spent the whole weekend producing, but...
Nice.
I was working on some new music for a project.
Okay.
That's a good excuse, though. That's a great excuse.
Yo, listen. That's what the people need to hear.
Doing production.
You had a good reason for
that's
missing
every day
out.
For me, though. You know what I mean?
You was working on it. You could be on that stage. For the
no days off.
Exactly.
That's what I'm talking about. No days off in the building. I don't want to sound biased, but I'm going to throw this at you, Quest. What's going on with the FIFA tournament, bro? What's going on? I know you following it. Yeah.
I stopped following a while back when my country got kicked off.
Oh, so you stopped watching?
I mean, I watch here and there. You know.
France, I think, won today, right?
Croatia. I don't know if France won, but I know Croatia. Wait, they got taken out?
I think they did. They got taken out today.
Nah, I think they won because it's saying that they got to play against France. Or did they play against France? I'm lost.
France won 1-0.
Against Croatia?
I think so.
Oh, yeah. So then I guess they out of it then. I told y'all.
So. I'm not sure, though, but I think France won. So
I pulled the same move because Nigeria, Nigeria, you know, Nigeria was the only team that was in it, and my family's from Cameroon, so that's our neighbor, so I was rocking with them. They had the hardest outfits. They were like one of the youngest teams, and they were out there giving a problem to everybody. So I was rocking with them, and then when they lost, I said, screw y'all, man, you know, not to show bias, but there wasn't that many brothers left in there, man. It was all Latinos and white dudes, and I'm sorry. I just didn't care for it at that point. Y'all can hate me. Everybody in Sunnyside know I'm like one of 0.3% black dudes out there, so I stick with my brothers hardcore, and if we're not in it, then I'm on to the next thing. But we are going to stop talking about that, all that other shenanigans, and we are going to focus on what we like to talk here, whether it's the DJ, it's a producer, it's an engineer, and right about now, we have someone that's actually more than just what I just said. He may not be a DJ himself, but he's a producer, a musician, a songwriter. We have Mark, my man Mark. You are here on Respect the DJ, and for all my people that don't know you, can you let them know who Mark is?
Well, I am Malfo from Malfo Productions. I run basically trying to put out albums every single year with featured artists,
nice.
Beat tapes, just put my creativity out into like the world right now,
okay.
And have my own sound and vibe going.
That's what's up.
I'm really just inspired lately. I've been making a lot of music, got a lot of features from a few artists that I really mess with. My boy, Ursa Major from the label Noir.
Nice.
He's a huge part of my music right now.
Okay.
His label, I have about 4 artists from his label that work directly with my music too.
Nice.
And I help produce some of their tracks and work with their music as well. So I have that circle. I have my circles of brother in New Jersey City, Hyro Kassad and Prof. I've been working with those guys. I recently just talked to them the other day. They doing good.
Excuse me.
And yeah, I had a show yesterday, like I said, last night. I was with, Solomon the Artist.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
I
nice.
I was with Logic Thompson.
Okay.
From Are You Dying Yet, if you don't know.
All right.
And I was also with my buddy Dorian Lake.
Dorian Lake.
He's a singer from like Shaolin, Staten Island.
Where you from, right?
I was about to ask. Yeah.
I was about to say, where are you hailing from so the people can know?
I'm from the streets of Shaolin. I am from Staten Island, New York.
Wait a second. Are you actually from like Staple Hill, right?
Stapleton
Projects? I mean, you say in the streets of Shaolin, and I've been through there. I don't like walking through the streets of Shaolin.
I'm just from Staten Island.
Oh, you're just from Staten Island? Yeah. Oh, you from the middle part where it's like, it's good.
It's okay.
You're that little drive away from the ferry where you're like, yo, listen, I got a gate. Y'all going to have to ring that bell possibly. You know what I'm saying? I dig it. Well, so now I was, for the people may not know, you just dropped a project.
I did just drop a project.
I believe it's called Tribe Chase.
Malfo Tribe Chase. You can find that on Apple Music, Spotify, and Tidal.
Okay, so now I was just listening to the album on my way up here in my Juno ride, and I gotta honestly say it's a definite hip hop album, but it's not something that I would say would have that normal Staten Island sound.
Yeah.
It doesn't have that dried out hip hop or saturated hip hop. It's like it's a really fresh sound to it.
I appreciate that.
Definitely. I would like you to talk more about that, because that also leads into your background as well.
Before making beats and producing and all that, I was a musician first and foremost. So I've been playing keys since I was 5 years old.
Nice.
My father, he's a bass player and guitar player. He's been playing those instruments since he was like 12, 14.
Oh, wow.
So music's been in his life his whole life. Then
he
think
just
about
passed
how
that down. Yeah.
I hear music all the time from when I was in the womb, a bass just going off and stuff. And all of a sudden I come out 5 years old. My dad has a music studio and he just brought a keyboard in the house. And he's like, oh, what are you looking to play? Bass? Trying to get me to play bass with him. And I was like, nah, I think I'll take keys.
Nice.
So, because I just wanted to be.
Don't want to have to be in pop
different.
Shadow. Don't want to take that Jordan moment and be like, he's nice, but I got to prove my point over that. Take your own lane.
And from there, basically, my pops told me, like, when I first picked up playing the piano, that I was, like, my ear was playing in keys, like, already. Like, I was figuring out notes and stuff for myself.
Okay.
So he immediately took me, like, to lessons till I was, like, about 12, 13. I took piano lessons, and I learned how to play, like...
Now, was, like, it a, was it those typical harsh story lessons where, like, you had the teacher, like, with the ruler smacking your finger, like, nah, you played the wrong one, or...
It was more, like, something I really wanted to do.
Right.
Because it was a part of, like, who I was. So, and I still feel that connection with music even to this day. Like,
nice.
Ever since I first picked up a piano, that was, like, who I was. That was my identity, almost in a sense. Mm-hmm. That music, that's just me 100%.
Right.
That's where I wanted to be, where I wanted my life to be. So that's why I took the directions I did. I took the paths I did. And at 16, actually, is when I really started getting more into production, into the computer,
okay,
and stuff, digital instruments.
Mm-hmm.
I got,
like,
Machine.
The Fruity Loops.
Yeah, I got Machine at that time. Around 18, 19, I was messing with Machine. And
wow, that you talking about, like, almost like the first edition of their,
yeah,
of their drum
MK2
machine.
Yeah, MK2 with, like, Machine 1. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, like, that was the first one. That was, like, the first kind of smooth...
Yeah,
smooth fly.
And it was still kind of, like, rough around the edges, mm-hmm, but it bumped my productions, like, another level.
Right. I've heard that from a lot of producers, that even producers who've come from the Akai MPC days and
yeah,
working on those, that when they got on a Machine, it was like a fluid,
yeah,
fluid production motions. Like, your,
yeah,
thoughts is manifesting, like,
it's
one,
right,
two.
There. Right,
that
when
is
you
nice.
Want something, you could get it. But the thing about the MPCs that are nice, like the little Akai drum machines and,
mm-hmm,
stuff, is that, like, you have that authentic sound from your,
right,
808s, and your kicks just sound,
you
know,
get that muddy
you
sound,
get that muddy,
you get that
nice,
grunge,
yeah,
yeah.
But the nice thing about Machine and digital world is just, it's so fluid, like you're saying. You need anything, you just pick it up and get it.
So now being that you did, you started on the Machine, and you know about the MPC, did you find yourself working on the MPC or trying to combine both of them workstations?
I never really had an MPC myself. What I would work on a lot of times with my drums was, mm, keyboards. So,
okay,
I would use like my Korg keyboard,
yeah,
with the drum kits and stuff.
They got
stuff.
The nice 808s,
yeah,
on the Korg, yes.
So, and I would use different, like, now I'm Team Roland. Like, I have a Roland Juno DI,
okay,
and a FA08.
Okay.
So those are my two main tools right now that I'm working
I think
on.
Those are the two keyboards that are on the back of the flyer that I use.
Yeah.
You had the Roland in the back. Yeah.
I can't hide it. Team Roland.
Yo, listen. What works, man? You can't step away from what works for you, man. Like, for me as a DJ, listen, I tell anyone, Traktor is technically better than Serato. But nobody has a Traktor box or a Traktor system in a club. Nobody was walking around with that. Serato was the industry standard.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it was anywhere you go, it's plug and play.
Of course.
You know? So now, if you look at Serato, they basically took the whole Traktor format and got,
yeah,
the four decks and everything. But everyone knows, if you use that program, you're going to move.
Yeah.
And if you get nice with it, you're going to sound better than someone,
yeah,
who, quote unquote, is supposed to be better than you just because you know what you're using.
Yeah.
You know,
exactly.
So
perfect your craft, basically,
yes,
at the end 100%. Of the day. Always know what you're working with.
Definitely.
Always know your production programs, too. Like, always know how to work your way around them. Learn it inside and out.
Yeah, I tell everybody, troubleshoot. Forget the manual.
Yeah.
Just push buttons when you first get it. Figure out,
yeah,
what does what, and then read a manual. So now,
what is that? It's fail often, fail fast, and it's like three things about
failing.
But you have to do that process in order to get better
to win
at anything.
Yeah.
In order to win at anything. So
definitely true. So now we had Quest, before we started our segment, we had Quest play one of your songs.
Yeah.
What was the name of that track?
That track was called Designer.
Designer.
Yeah.
Now, I was talking while off air, and I was like, yo, that had the only Outkast feel, like old school AT Aliens. You know what I'm saying? Whatchamacallit, their second album. Like, I was like, yo, you played all this? And you was like, yeah,
yeah,
this is you. Like this is what,
yeah,
you do. So are you into sampling, being that you're a musician who plays a lot of instruments?
What's funny is, like, I find myself sampling myself a lot. Like,
nice.
I'll there was this one time I lost a beat, and I had it, like, only recorded on my Snapchat video, and the video was fast-forwarded. So what I did with that was I took the audio from the video,
mm-hmm,
I dumped it into Pro Tools, And when I was in Pro Tools, I made a loop out of it. And that wound up becoming one of the songs of my project called Blessed Life. It's
for
like
real.
This loop that's in the background. Because I lost the beat for first week.
Gunshots to giving yourself paychecks. Gunshots to giving yourself paychecks. Royalty moves. I like that.
But I have recently, because of a few producers that have been pushing me, and I'm not going to mention no names yet. Maybe next time around. But,
yeah, definitely.
These people have been like giving me some... basically some tips and stuff, and they show me how to sample outside of like myself and how to get creative with like other people's stuff. So I'm learning every day too.
So let's give the people a little walkthrough of what a studio session is at Malfo Productions. And because you play the keys, and you was telling me that you also play a couple of other instruments, the drums.
I can play the drums, the keys. I play a little bit of sax.
Okay.
But most times, if I ever need like other instruments and stuff, I have a few musicians I call on to like just play a line for me or something. Or I could just get it myself off of like one of my keyboards.
So what would a session be like?
A session with me, basically.
If you calling in the guns. If you calling in the guns and everything.
Basically, I'll make whatever you're hearing in your head. If you come to me with ideas and you have something in your mind that you want to get out, something that you think that, oh, I want a beat that sounds like this, but not this. Things like that I do a lot for artists because, you know, they want a vibe, but they don't want to just take a beat from,
they don't want to mimic
something that was already done, or take just Drake's beat or something that was already out. So it's like, could you make me something that vibes like this? Could you make me something that rides like this? I know I can.
Right.
So I basically, I take the time, I sit with the artist, I learn what they want one-on-one.
Okay.
I basically do a little, like, sit down, talk type of thing. Then after that, we get to the sessions.
Yeah.
And we work on what they really want.
Okay.
So I did something like that recently for my boy Nick Moody. We made a track. He basically played me the track from Rick and Morty. I don't know if you ever heard that. Da, 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 da. It's like a slow piano.
In the show. In the
it's
show.
In the one show. Of the,
yeah, yeah.
And
I've seen every episode.
He wanted something that rocked just like that. The slow drums, the slow like kicks and everything. So I just came in, gave him a piano line that fit in that kind of realm. Same type of slow vibe. And we just made it happen from there.
Oh,
didn't
nice.
Mimic no lines. And right. we came up with something even doper in my mind. So
that's what's up. So I see how you're moving with that now. Being that you were playing them, you play the keys and you do your own production outside of just, you know, working for other people. What was the kind of mind space you was in making your Tribe Chase album?
Tribe Chase was 9.5 months of hard work. Let me
oh,
just
really?
Say that.
I haven't heard an artist say that in a long time. That one project took almost a year of putting together and cooking up. Most of the time, people is talking about, yo, I worked on this project like 30 days, son, and I knocked it out. And it sounds like 30 days worth of crap. You know? But yours, like I said, it was different. It had a fresh air vibe to it.
I appreciate that a lot.
You know, doesn't sound like anything that's out right now.
Thank you.
I could guarantee that. It doesn't sound like anything that's out right now. And the artists that are on there are dope, and they're up and coming artists, because I saw that you worked with about maybe 4 artists, but repeatedly, you know, features.
There was about 11 artists.
Oh, there are 11 different artists.
But they're featured on like different songs and stuff.
Okay.
So these artists I was just people I bumped into on my path, like producing for different people and doing different things. The project mainly was just to focus on like my production and what I could do, show that I could have different vibes. There's love songs in there.
Yeah.
There's like there's songs where they're just singing. And there's no rapping.
Right.
There's songs in there where like they're just rapping the whole time. There's freestyle songs. Like I was in Texas at South by Southwest. We opened up for Wyclef. I opened up with Ursa Major and the label Noir.
Wow.
Yeah. And that was a vibe in itself. But I was up there playing keys for him.
Mm-hmm.
And basically, when we got back to the Airbnb, I was with Jay Osama, who's a producer out in Long Island. And me and Jayo, he gave me some drums. And I was just like, oh, I'll put some keys to that.
Right.
We wound up making a whole beat, had 4 artists like freestyle on it, and then we put that on the project too.
Oh,
like
wow.
Things like that. We recorded that in an Airbnb. and the shit still sounded dope.
I gotta honestly say, like, you basically saying, like, you made your album just vibing.
Because
that's what it feels. Yeah. That's what it feels like, and it's a straight vibe from the tracks that I've heard. Like, the first track, Lucy, caught me off guard. I wasn't expecting that. Like, it was cool, got the little swing, and then the singing, I was like, oh. And then the lyrics on there, I'm like, oh, he's spitting some words too. But the singing is what got me. And then I was like, okay.
It's my brother Dorian Lake right there.
Yo.
Yeah.
You set the album off right. I'm actually going to finish listening to it on my way home after the show today.
Much love right now.
Yeah, we're going to, we're actually going to take a short, but we're not going to pay no bills right now. We're going to go straight through and pay bills afterwards. You know, I would like to let the people know what you have coming up, you know, in the near future. If you got any shows, if you got anything, any other projects coming up.
I'm working on booking more shows at the moment right now, so I'll have more on my Instagram. You can follow me at Malfo, M-A-L-F-O, _18. I will definitely have more flyers up and stuff for my upcoming events. And you can just peep my live as well, and my story. But right now, what I've been working on for the most part, I've really been trying to just catch another vibe of, like, production. You know, I got a little upset by, like, some of the things happening in the industry, people dying.
Right.
The beef between people in the industry. And I'm, like, a person of love. You know, right. I like to show love and support to the people around me. So, like, my vibe recently has just been, like, I'm just trying to make music that fits that type of vibe. You know, love, loyalty, honesty,
yeah,
things like that.
A lot of stuff that the world needs.
Yeah, and it's my production right now. I feel like because of the tips I got off my first project from people, and like I said, you always learn no matter who you are.
Right.
So you can be the biggest person in the game, you're still learning. So, but at the end of the day, I learned something like with just like how to bump my low end harder and how to get like certain things like on another vibe, another wave. So there's things like that that I'm also working on and trying to factor into my music now going forward. Of course, you know, I have the archive of beats for anybody that comes to me and wants something. I also have, you know, the studio sessions I've been setting up with people, and should have my website up soon. I'm trying to get t-shirts.
Oh, you're trying to get the whole shebang-a-bang with the merch, the site. That's smart. I mean, you definitely have to brand yourself. You always got to put yourself out there. I wanted to ask you, being that you are someone that's been doing this for years, but you're still like on a come up level.
Yeah.
How is it working with other engineers? Because engineers tend to move like I'm gonna die in that position. You know what I mean? I'm gonna die. You know, and we had spoke about it. A lot of people that know me also know I do audio engineering myself.
Yeah.
And I've gone through my own experiences with people. You know what I'm saying? Engineers not wanting to share techniques and stuff, but how has it been for you?
A lot of times I start with sharing some of my techniques to break the ice a little bit with people. If I notice that there's like a vibe like that, I know people don't want to share everything about like what their techniques. I don't share everything about what I do, you know. And I understand that because everyone has their own techniques at the end of the day. They want to archive. That's my diamond in the rough.
Yep.
So that's what makes their beats pop the way they pop. But I think the more you just sit around people that are producers and engineers, the more you see how people make beats, the more you see how people mess with their kicks and their drums and all their synth sounds, how they pan things, how they edit it with reverb or anything. Just watch people. At the end of the day, just watch what they're doing. You won't have to ask questions. You can learn off of just watching what people are doing.
Definitely.
That's how I learned a lot of what I was doing for the past 3 years. With my boy Jade Hamilton out in Queens, like, he taught me a lot in my production. He bumped my drums to another level.
Right.
He basically took like what I knew and he was like, why don't you try doing things like this? So, you know, sometimes it's good to just get under people's wings too.
Yeah, no.
Have people like teach you something.
Yeah, no, I always encourage Quest. I encourage a lot of other DJs, yo, go to other people's parties.
Yeah.
Don't just stay focused on your party. Go to other people's parties. Not stealing nothing. It's you hearing that vibe. You seeing what's going on. Big shout out to my man DJ Trace in the building, man. What's going on, boy? I saw you sneaking here. Hey, you trying to be slick. trying to walk
he's
in
like
with
a ninja, yo.
Listen, he got that Ewing's athletics, man. He's silky smooth, man. He walking on air right now with them Ewing athletics.
Poof,
yeah, I know. I just saw him like he just floated in. It's all good. But this is what we do here at Respect the DJ, man. Don't forget. Right after us, we got the Fix coming on at 7 o'clock at their new time, doing big things from 7 to 9 p.m. I see you, boy. Them checks is moving for you, huh? Them checks is moving. I like that. I like your style. But we have reached the point that we all hate here on the show. This is when we got to say our goodbyes to everybody. So real quick, give everybody your handle, your IG, the website. Well, I know you're working on the website, but where they could reach you and let the people know.
Okay, so my Instagram is at Malfo, M-A-L-F-O, underscore 1818. My Facebook is Malfo Productions, if you want to like the Facebook page. And my website is MalfoProductions.com, right? Yes, MalfoProductions.com. I'd ask Jackie behind the camera.
Yes. Big shout to Jackie in the building. She was... I give the official gunshots. She walked in here, and she's been serious behind that camera. I've been amazed low-key watching with the good basketball peripherals. Big shout to Jackie. She double-fisted with the cameras right now. I like your style. Quest, what's good, man? Let the people know what's going on, what you got going on.
Just go to my IG page at the original DJ Quest, and the rundown's right there.
Bird, that's it? You ain't going to tell them? You're not doing any parties this week or anything?
Check my IG page. Stop being lazy.
Oh, nice. I like you. There you go. Make the people do their job. Well, I'm for the special ed peoples too. I'm going to tell y'all, y'all could go find me at DJ Swift 37. I'm also the handler of at Respect the DJ with DJ Swift page on IG, and our Facebook page is still in the process of being made. I got it up. I'm just trying to get everything connected for the people. We're going to be doing big things. I'm going to be at Stacks this week, this Friday on 77th and 2nd Avenue. And I'm also going to be at Karma Lounge doing the Z-Boozy Day Party. We got our Z-Boozy brunch going on. And we got a special guest chef coming in doing his famous French toast. So we're going to be doing our thing, having it rocking and rolling for y'all. But always remember, peace, love, share, and be music. This is how we like to do it here at Respect the DJ with DJ Swift. We out of here.
Be
test me, you don't
need a quick cameo in
the
building.
Yo, books kick the rest, G.
Shout out to my phone.
Hey, yo, what up? The crew bringing the ruckus.
Stay tuned. DTF Raiders, Drake. Fix show coming up next.
Cause Cutler's getting ducky. The dough, you can't touch the flow. It's me, the nigga with G.
D-O-K-S.
So say yes and bust your caliber when I pop shit and rock shit like Metallica. Stay through the hearts of them snake fake niggas. Them all up in my face, jealous of my tape niggas. So honey, shake your fingers and show me what you got. Dice effects with the real hip hop.
Got a brother rolling, so bad I'm about to pass out. Wanna dig you